I have such mixed feelings about Norway's Eurovision selection show. On one hand, I love it, but on the other, it frustrates me so much. But at least they picked the right song this year. But before we begin, if you are new here, please hit subscribe. I make videos about all things Eurovision that you'll love. So yes, indeed, on February 19th, Norway held the final of Melodi Grand Prix, their selection for Eurovision 2022.
Velkommen til finale I Melodi Grand Prix 2022!
And of course, we had a winner. Subwoofer.
Vinneren av Melodi Grand Prix 2022 Subwoofer!
And I honestly couldn't be happier. It's exactly the right kind of wacky sh** that I love to see at Eurovision. And yes, it is ridiculous. Two bright yellow wolf men singing about upping their potassium intake. But the way they present it, the seriousness in which they carry themselves stops it being a joke act. And I just can't help but love it. And before that wolf eats my grandma, give that wolf a banana, give that wolf. Eat your grandma, yum, yum. And as for our runner-up, Norsk, who I really didn't see coming. I was someone you love, now I'm someone you hate. Now, it's not that it's a bad song, it's actually a really great pop tune, and the boys sing it brilliantly. I can totally, totally see why Norway loved this band so much. They're so authentically themselves. But for me, it just didn't grab my attention. It just wasn't on my radar. Compare it to, say, Hammer of Four, probably my joint top song of the night. I stole the hammer of Thor. Stole the hammer of Thor. I honestly don't think I've ever heard anything quite like it before. It's so commanding and powerful. The way Oda belts out those screams just had me glued to my screen. And it's so stripped back, it could almost be an a cappella number. It just sounded so unlike anything I've heard before. And then there was Elsie Bay. It seemed like it was going to be between her and Subwoofer on the night. I admit I wasn't entirely into it. For me, it just starts a little bit too slow. But when it did build into its crescendo, it was stunning. She performed that beautifully. I've made up my mind, so you no longer have to deserve my love. You could tell she was pouring her heart and soul into it. It really did deserve that top placing. And as for the last of the top four, Norway voted for Made of Glass. And again, it's not a terrible song. Sophie's vocals were brilliant, but to me, it just felt a little bit MGP by the numbers. But our love was made of glass. It was perfectly fine, but it just wasn't anything particularly special. And as for my worst song of the night, it would have to be Christian Ingebrigtsen. Probably butchered that. I wanna wake up next to you. It just felt a little bit dated, honestly. If he'd sung that 20 years ago, it would have been fine, but in the year of our Lord 2022, it just didn't fit right with the rest of the songs. And maybe it's because I had high expectations of him. He was in the band A1 and he also wrote Ulrike's winning entry, Attention. But when it came to the live performance, I was just a bit let down. Overall though, MGP was once again a very, very mixed bag. The quality as ever was top. Not. It was beautifully presented. It was great to see a crowd back again, and the talent really was great this year. But it is
as ever, the format that lets the show down. We saw it last year with Tix and Kaino. Our top two acts were both pre-qualified for the final.
Nå det to artister igjen, og her kommer de. North Kid og Subwoofer.
Which just makes the 5 weeks of semi-finals feel a little bit pointless, you know? Oh, and before I forget, how was that performance of Fallen Angel better than the one he did in Rotterdam? That stripped back acoustic version he did on Saturday night, that was gorgeous. That's what they should have sent last year. But enough about me. What about you, humble viewer? Was Subwoofer the worthy winner, or should someone else have taken home the crown instead? Let me know down below in the comments. And don't forget to hit thumbs up and click subscribe for more. Next week, there'll be a review of Australia's national final, which I'm very excited for. So make sure you stick around for that one. And to keep on watching, just click the links on screen now.